Hey everybody. I wanted to do another full play, and I did the Bioshock Infinite one a long time ago. On the Riot channel, where Rich and I have been playing Minecraft, but Minecraft isn't really a game that you full play because it never really stops. You keep inventing projects for yourselves. But I was like, what do I want to play? And this is my answer. This is Splinter Cell Blacklist. Sam Fisher chokes out people for the American dream. And I think that, like, part of it is I played it before and it's a really fun game. But also, there's a lot of interesting stuff to talk about with it. About geopolitics and philosophies of ethics and freedom. And there's a bunch of really, it's... If you want a game that's like a fucked up imagining of the American dream, it's hard to do better than Splinter Cell. We're going to play on Rookie, because I'm going to be talking the whole time, and that way you won't have to watch me just bomb out on on every single level like three times while I'm talking. Guam! Home to a whole bunch of American citizens who can't vote in elections. Who did a great piece? John Oliver did a great piece on that. I'll link it in the show notes. Also, why are these guys, like, live streaming their attack?
Get in, Dingo! Get in here! Yeah, go!
What is the deal with the camera code at the bottom?
You think America can't find you?
No need, General. We're coming to America.
Oh. That's Sadiq, the guy... spoilers, for a game that came out 3 years ago. Sadiq is like the last boss of the game.
Contract says no weapons. Not on this kind of op.
Who needs to know?
General McGowan. But this might make you feel better. Little souvenir I picked up in Indonesia.
The contract says no weapons.
If I need a karambit for aerial recon, we've got bigger
problems. Here's a knife.
Charlie with that sack phone.
Hey, sorry. Just putting the finishing bits of awesome on this puppy.
Signal I love Charlie.
Skips base combo completely.
Charlie fits every, like,
keeps the DOD
youthful millennial hacker vibe that you could possibly imagine. And in my head... My fan casting of this is
Sam.
Zachary Levy from Chuck as Charlie.
Let's move.
What was that clip to?
Uploading. We're in.
We're in.
Teams, this is King. We are go.
Oh, man.
Han says go.
We're all go now.
Knight says go. Rook is go.
Queen says go.
I will point out that they use this chess call sign
a few days.
In this scene,
single,
and
right?
Never again
no,
in the whole game.
I'm gonna take that as a no.
Stop hacking base IT. We're guests here.
Yeah, but they make it so easy.
Oh, Andy's a super genius.
Video's up.
I've got it. Site F encryption keys, 40 days until expiration.
Hostiles are down.
Let's go.
Bishop's been hit.
Jam everything and move out. The blacklist is live. Now.
Anderson Tower, this is Paladin 02 requesting.
Man, I love playing games for the second time. You always wind up seeing
radio
the bits that you missed.
Radio's working fine. Anderson Tower, this is Paladin 02 requesting permission to lift off from Chopper Pad Alpha Niner. Well, we're behind. Fuck the protocol.
Well, fuck it. It's not like we care if the airspace is clear. It's not like there's safety regs or anything like that. Fuck it. We're just taking off.
Leave him.
Alright, cuddle this close. This grenade will save your life. I'm dying. This grenade will save your life.
Bravo team, report.
Hey, you had all these chest call signs. And then you just have Bravo team? You can't have, like, white and black? All of Guam gone.
Holy shit! Mayday, mayday, mayday. Paladin 02, we're going down.
Don't mind us, we're crashing our helicopter. If only we'd waited for protocol. And that's Splinter Cell Blacklist. We're dead, everybody. We were just in a helicopter crash. The tragic death of Sam Fisher, damn it.
We make the base just outside the perimeter. Shake a light.
We're a big target in our crashed helicopter.
Vic, give me a hand. I'm stuck. Charlie Sackville.
Yeah.
Oh, shit. You guys okay? What the fuck is happening?
Chopper's down. We're fine. Munitions depot must have been hit. Where are you?
Hiding under a truck with my laptop. Guys, all the radio channels are down. It's gotta be an RF jammer. There's a signal northwest of you.
All right, you sit tight. We'll find the jammer. Come on.
That's the other thing I love Charlie for, is he's sort of... he's your spirit guide. Don't mind me, I'm just bending the steel this chopper's made of.
Eyes open, Sam.
Alright. Now we're gonna hobble to victory. I'm gonna try and remember how to play this game. I have a knife. So one of the interesting things about Splinter Cell as a game is there are sort of three ways you can play it. There are a couple of different ways you can play it, but it gives you points based on three ways. Ghost, which is entirely stealth-based. And so you bypass enemies, you knock them out, it's entirely... The goal is to be non-lethal. And if you can leave someone alone entirely, then that's best.
Vic, don't move.
Combat, which doesn't have a cool name, and it's just combat, is, you know, the standard sort of guns blazing, rush around, shoot everybody. Now, given that you are, like, made of tinfoil, like a regular human being who gets shot by bullets, it's unclear to me that that is not the hardest style of game. But my favorite, and the one that we're going to spend most of our time doing, because that's the way I like playing the game, is Panther, which is stealth and lethal. Silenced weapons, sniper rifles. Alright, so we want to go lethal. Get him! Excuse me! He's probably fine. Alright, so now I have a silenced pistol with infinity bullets. Here we go. Sneak up all careful-like. And that little light glows whenever I'm stealthed, which is super useful and kind of off-putting. Hey, guys. Excuse me. Also, I'm really bad at this game, just FYI. Excuse me, guys. There we go. So part of the reason why I enjoy Panther is it lets me shoot dudes quietly when I do something like that, which is pretty much all the time. I'm not patient. I'm especially not patient when I'm, like, recording. So I shoot people in the head. Hey, man. What's up? Sleepy time. Sleepy time. Oh, it's Grenade Hero. He looks more like one of my soldiers, so I mean... This is an interesting, like, bit of compassion that Sam Fisher shows.
Know how to disable that thing?
I'm working on it.
How's the kid?
Don't ask.
Like,
Charlie, we're in.
I wonder if that guy's like, maybe they'll save me. Maybe I live through this. Although I guess living through that and finding out and getting found out would mean that you wind up.
Do you see a blue button?
Yeah.
Hit it.
What are you saying? What are you telling me, buddy?
Yeah, I mean, you do, it's like secret prison.
Can't stop the blacklist.
Grenade! Whoa. Vic, buddy.
Word of a stunning attack on the massive U.S. military installation on the island of Guam.
The deadliest strike on a U.S. base since Pearl Harbor.
A group calling themselves...
I gotta admit, I love these kinds of effects.
Released an internet video... with chilling footage from the attack to lay out their demands. They're calling the attacks the Blacklist.
The Blacklist.
The Blacklist.
Awesome. I wonder if they had a soldier record that. Or if they had, like, a cameraman with them.
Every 7 days, we have one demand. You have soldiers in 153 countries. Bring your troops home.
Your troops home.
Now. For every week, we will attack you. We will not negotiate.
You will not stop the Blacklist.
You have 7 days until the next attack.
The choice is yours.
We are the engineers.
We are the engineers.
That is a really interesting
What's
demand.
Our status?
Paladin 1 and the 4th Echelon team are ready
also,
Madam President, but we can't locate Mr. Fisher.
Madam President? Hell yeah. I have never played another Splinter Cell game, so I don't know if she's been the President the whole time. This is my very first Splinter Cell game. And possibly also my last, but we'll see.
And I don't have any. 4th Echelon needs to find them, and it can't do that without a leader.
It's distraught, Vic.
Oh, man.
One of Vic's men comes with me, no questions asked.
You can have Charlie Cole. And Grimm's daughter has recruited one of the CIA's best for mission support. Isaac Briggs.
Who is Grimm's other out. Me?
She didn't want you on this mission either. Sorry, Sam, that's a non-starter. Nobody works better with you than she does.
Man. Anna Grimm's daughter is
Welcome
awesome.
Welcome to 4th Echelon, Mr. Fisher.
I love her character design. Like, she's got all these hard edges. Like, it's interesting because she doesn't look like she's a 20-something. Like, they do a lot of work to sort of make Charlie look young and make everyone else look older.
With this engineer's organization.
Nothing yet.
I mean, Sam Fisher, on the other hand, is like 75.
What about the names? American Freedom, American Blood.
Potential attacks, each with a timer.
5 days before America.
Come on, us just sitting in a plane?
And counting. We're running analytics to find the target locations as we speak.
Why are we sitting there?
I'll get you up to speed on the plane.
Prototype military.
Oh, I guess if we were like taking
Loaded
off.
With custom modifications. Armory, infirmary, holding cell, every resource that you'd have on the ground.
Fully mobile. It's like the good old days. Problem breaks.
Alright.
It's got my subdermal radio put in. Felt like someone used a jackhammer.
This puppy makes Air Force One look
Chekhov's subdermal radio.
Do you want to discuss potential upgrades?
Later. Walk me through this.
News and internet data mining, predictive analytics, photo and video forensics.
Translation. We have a lot of computers.
Systems and facial recognition integration from the CIA, NSA, DCS, FBI.
All in real.
We know a lot of scary things.
This is what you were bragging about? Yes, am I?
Strategic mission interface. We've made significant improvements since the early system Charlie worked on. I'll let him get you up to speed.
Best thing is, you can control everything from right here or from your OPSAT when you're on the ground.
Impressive.
Okay, well, let me know if you need anything. I'm gonna check out my new digs.
Thanks, Charlie.
All right. So let's use the SMI.
Hey, Sam, almost forgot.
About your magic phone menu thing.
Sort of like your SMI light when you're on the ground. Data transmissions, drone controls, scanning.
Gotcha.
All you gotta do is slave it to the SMI, do a couple of calibrations, and you're good to go.
Thanks, Charlie.
I love me some calibrations, Charlie. I like that there's actually a calibration. I forgot about that. Like, we could have done this at any time. And the game's like, no. We'll make you calibrate when you think you should calibrate. Alright, so let's go to the safe house.
A protester outside a U.S. military installation in Ansbach, Germany was shot and injured this morning by a sentry who thought the man was a possible threat. Gunter Schmidt, 34,
okay,
twice
in
the leg when he approached the base of
strike. What do we have in Benghazi?
Alright.
My contact is at a CIA safe house. They've detained a subject with intel on Guam, but no one gets to ask questions until they're done with them.
How'd they nab him?
Didn't. He just walked in their office.
Look, how do we know he isn't some psycho with a sick sense of humor? There's something you're not telling me?
Dude's name is Andrew Coben. Does that mean anything?
Now, my understanding is if you played another Splinter Cell game before this, you'd like, oh, what?
Well, wait.
But
we know this guy.
What we need to know, what would make a wanted arms dealer turn himself into the CIA right after Guam?
All due respect, why don't we just leave the interrogation to the CIA?
Forget the company man bullshit, Briggs. You're on our team, man.
Translation, because America.
He's our only connection to the engineers. We're not trusting this to someone else.
Who is Andre Coben?
Andre Coben pretended to kill my daughter to give someone leverage over me.
Oh, how is he even still alive?
Good question.
What's our move, Sam?
We fight the CIA?
Show me the safe house.
Really? Now that's a bad neighborhood.
I know, weird, right? Because usually the CIA tries to keep their Middle East ops super obvious.
Focus.
I also like how professional everyone else is. Like, you know, insert joke beat. And they're like, listen,
always looks easy on this.
What are you doing? Why are you?
To be clear, Sam, we are talking about an extraction, not killing him.
You're up. Show me viable positions for Overwatch.
Best sight lines are here and there.
Looks good. Grab a suppressed sniper kit.
Am I providing cover or am I taking out the target, sir?
Charlie, rustle us up some transport, would you? Somebody have blends? Panel van?
You got it.
Nothing blends like a panel van.
You just worry about a viable spot for exfil. Something here. Everyone clear? Let's make this prep quick.
Alright, let's learn how to play the game.
We are go for Benghazi.
Alright, so we're gonna fiddle with the loadout a bit. It wouldn't be a real, like, Tom Clancy game if you couldn't just fiddle with your loadout a whole ton. So, we only have $70,000, and we apparently have to buy things. But we're going to do fine with all of that. My op suit, though. I have the Game of the Year edition, the Deluxe edition. So, I have a bunch of cool-ass operation suit stuff. So we're going to grab that, because it just negates 90% of the other stuff, so I won't have to spend a ton of time fiddling with my op suit for the rest of the... Leave a comment if you want me to change the color of the lights. I like the white ones because I'm colorblind, so it makes it easier to tell them apart from other lights. So we've got the boots, pants, the torso. All right. So now this is our dress-up mode. Goggles. Let's get a pistol. Let's get the USP 45. And equip some upgrades. Pistol's basically my primary weapon. And the alternate weapon is your big gun. I like sniper rifles, but I don't have enough money for one yet. And we need something quiet, because quiet is the name of the game. And right now, the only thing we have that's quiet is the thing we're already equipped on. Gadgets, we can equip 3 more gadgets. But we don't have any more gadgets, so we're good to go. And we can rename this to Tactical. I can't put an exclamation point in the name. Damn you, Tom Clancy. All right. So we're going to try to do most of this with a pistol, but we'll see where we get.
Grim, give me a sit rep.
Don't mind me. I'm just a white man with a backpack.
Briggs, you have a visual on the safe.
I'm blending in.
I just got here.
With my black leather jacket and blue jeans.
I'm entering the plaza.
Don't mind me. I'm just like everyone else.
Get eyes from the southwest corner of the plaza.
Excuse me, everyone.
Grim, keep trying to reach our contact. Let me know if you get through.
Copy.
Yep. Don't mind me. I'm definitely not some sort of American operative. I'm just walking around in blue jeans talking to myself.
Bathroom, you got one.
Yep. Do, do, do. Hello, citizen. I'm blending.
Any update from your contact?
I clearly don't look like some kind of CIA agent with my backpack and Ray-Bans or aviators. Now I'm really super blending.
Status.
Still all right. Them. I'm seeing a lot of militia down there. Might get loud.
Moving to the side entrance.
Lethal. Oh, we have the stun gun too. Sweet. Sometimes non-lethal is good. And we'll but most of the time, we're just gonna pop dudes for America. Game is still playing itself because it's trying to teach me how to play it. Excuse me. Alright, so now what we do is mark them because Sam Fisher is a psychic and he can mark people. And we execute. Execute is a delightful mechanic that lets you, like, shoot 3 people at the same time. It's really cool, and it would be even cooler if AI couldn't already do that. And, more importantly, that later in the game, basically everybody wears a helmet. So shooting people in the head becomes sort of useless, because you have to do it twice. And the execute only does it once. Excuse me, sirs. You think that guy's looking at me? He's probably not looking at me. Wow. Really? Oh no, and they're like, Everything's quiet. Find and retrieve dead drops. Is there a dead drop near here? Is that why it's telling me to do that? Dead drops, so there's a lot of ways, because of the money mechanic, there's a lot of ways to just make money. And that's fun. Oh, there it is, yep. Hello.
Charlie, found a flash drive.
Contextual buttons, yay. I hate contextual buttons. Always manage to find the one little spot in the context where they don't. Those guys are out of range of my gun.
Out the window and traverse the ledge.
Nice work.
Oh. So we're going out the window. Excuse me. I'm glad that guy spotted me. For a second, I thought he wasn't going to. Come on, me, civilians. I don't know what happens if you shoot them. I've never really tried. I don't intend to either. I'm an American and everything, but I'm not that American. I'm no Donald Trump. I could be hiding anywhere. Sir? Don't mind me. I'm invisible. Yep, I'm invisible. I also don't really know where I'm going. I'm trying to look around the corner with my psychic peripheral vision, but it's not working. Excuse me.
I'm in position, Sam.
Any sign of our contact?
Can't confirm.
Roger that.
Do 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 do. Held space to rescue!
Roger that.
It's not him. Confirmed Coven was in here, Briggs.
Right place, right build, I assume, sir.
Make assumptions when I'm on the ground. Clear?
Sam, talk to me.
Oh, Muffin.
Contact's been made. He's dead.
Got more militia en route. Advise you move out, sir.
Right, I need options. Now would be good.
Give me a minute.
Oh, yeah. It's all me, baby. Pass the phone to the ops head. I can hack this cheap bootleg crap easy.
Thanks, man.
All right, Charlie, I'm patched.
Okay, yes.
I also, I love the visual
wow,
stuff. Like, it just,
it
gives you a lot more than Sam Fisher is standing in a location talking. And I like that he's always in motion. He's always sort of moving, he's checking corners, he's...
Enemy transpo dropping hostiles at least a dozen.
Transpo? Transpo? You couldn't just say truck? How army are we? Oh, time to get sneaky. Do-do-do. Time to get real sneaky. Cue to drop down. Can I hit that guy from here? Nope, no chance. that guy from here. Nope, still no chance. Well, they're gone now, so let's not worry about it. I'm inconspicuous.
I'm uploading a shortcut to the police station. It'll be on your offset.
Roger that.
Can I hit that guy from here? Nope. Oh, it's a restock, though. So I can restock all the stuff I didn't use. Good of us to leave a bunch of submachine gun ammo out here. And presumably some grenades. Alright. Oh, is this like a zipline thing? Oh, wow. Thank you, game. We just started playing ourselves here. Cool. Do-do-do. Hostiles taken down non-lethally can be revived by their allies. Translation, why I don't leave survivors. You should come up here. I promise it's a really good time. We've got a cool benefits plan. There's some... Hup! Oh, watch that first step there, though. Yeah, this thing's got zero range. Isn't there a guy, like, below me? I love third-person games because you can just, like, psychically view them. Oh, no, they're there. Keep searching. Everything is fine. There's the guy.
I'm getting no response from Mansoor. Have you seen him?
No, he's fine.
I have no idea where he is. I'll go find
him. Shh, don't worry about it. Don't worry about it. I'm just gonna... Oh, excuse me. That was the most... I'm sorry, that was very awkward. That was... Oh, there we go. Oh, there's a hole, like, way down over here. Excuse me. Whoop. Don't mind me, just shooting dudes in the noggin. Only one left. I am the worst at Stealthman games. I'm so bad. Like, it is. It's like stealth kill two guys, then just shoot nine guys in the face. Like, that was every guy from here to basically the police station. Hop. Hop, hop. Man, Sam Fisher's ability to, like, hold himself up by his hands is impressive.
He's the biggest on Langley's most wanted. If you capture him, we'll arrange for pickup.
Cool. Let's make sure we capture him. Stun gun.
HVT secured.
And high value targets are worth money. So we try and capture them whenever we can so we can unlock cool ass new guns, at least until we get all the guns we want, and then we don't care anymore.
Grim, what's the best route for Coven?
Head down towards street level.
Got it.
That seems awesome. I am blending in right now. I am just... Oh. I'm like not even here, man. See, it's all dark.
Just keep going.
Do 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 do. I am the worst. Excuse me, sir. Excuse me. I have places to go. I'm sorry. There we are. Your noggin had an accident. Ideally, I get them before they get a shot off. Like that? Oh, what are you talking about? Excuse me. Doom, the stealth game. I am the worst. Alright, let's get out into the light. There are ways to just, like, sneak through this and basically kill nobody. I just don't ever use them. Oh, check my night vision. No. You can get... So one of the first things I try to unlock is sonar vision. Yeah, there's a dog in there. Ah! Stupid bulletproof fences? If that fence hadn't been bulletproof, I wouldn't have had that whole problem. Yeah, dogs are annoying. They can smell you. They work like dogs.
I'm almost on site. I scoped out a rooftop 200 meters south of the police station.
I have the worst stealth habits. Excuse me, sir. Okay. Now, there's some dogs in there, I bet. Shh. Everything's fine. Don't worry about it. See? Don't worry about it. Sorry, dog. You were giving away my position. I can't allow you to do that. Let's climb through here. Onto the broken glass! We're sneaky as fuck. Excuse me, sir. Alright. Now we're gonna come around. We got one guy over there. Oh, look, I marked him. I'm like a pro. And we got one guy over there. So we're gonna deal with that guy first. Oh, or not. Is that guy gonna find somebody that I, you know, left behind? No. Excuse me. Yeah, I could have bypassed him. That's true. These are police, by the way. We're now in the police station. These are police in Benghazi that I am killing. I'm pretty sure. Nope. Like, this is... Oh, no. The militia have taken over the police station, so we're not actually killing cops.
Best bet is a secure interrogation room. Top floor, south side.
Brakes, pull out. Get the van and rendezvous at extraction.
Copy that.
Do-do-do. Excuse me. Don't mind me. I'm just, you know, hanging out. Shh. Just hanging out. It's fine. Everything's fine. SMG. I like that that dude hasn't noticed his friend, like, lying in a heap. Don't mind me. Well, got lucky. I'll take it. There's a part of me that's like, I want to say that's what actual combat is like, is you just sort of fire at something and someone until you get lucky, but that seems like a really unfortunate thing to say. And the truth is, I don't actually know.
If they set up shop in the police station, they've set up computers. Plug in your offsite if you find one. We should be able to get some useful data from it.
Ah, blacklist laptops, yes. I am Haxman. Haxman?
Charlie, found a laptop with possible intel.
$40,000!
Like
stealing money. Well, I mean, stealing money from terrorists, but...
One more time. Why did you run to the Americans?
I told you it has nothing to do with you. Nothing, I swear to God!
So... You are saying we are not important enough to turn us in? Is that it?
No.
Oh my God.
I'm not saying that. No.
What
are you saying?
You talk too much.
I like Coben. I think he's a really fun character. He's really interesting. I don't know anything about him from the previous Splinter Cell games. But spoilers, he'll be around for a while.
Okay. Fuck it. Told them everything. Okay.
Alive?
No.
This is the perfect spot to use an execute.
Thank you. Who are you? CIA? Oh, you have got to be fucking shitting me!
I just love the image of an arms dealer just like shuffling away like that.
I'm here to save what you know. Sit.
Sam, it's about to get ugly. Local talent's closing on your position.
Package is secure. Briggs, what's your 20?
Inbound with the van.
Holy shit, he is here to save me.
Move. Now.
Ow!
Let's go.
Oh, man.
You'll keep me safe, right?
So we gotta get over to that window. And there's a guy there. That tells me is we have not yet neutralized all hostiles. Don't mind me being psychic, seeing around corners. Yep. There we go. Nice. I think the last time I did that, I totally blew it. I had to, like, shoot a bunch of guys with Coben just, like, around, with one hand around Coben's neck.
The hell, man? Why?
Do it.
Listen, I hope you can support your own body weight with your arms. Like, that is a recipe for just knocking him into the courtyard. I hope after being tortured that you can just do a pull-up for, you know... What? Hmm. While hurtling down a line at speed. Scores? I officially don't care about scores. They just sort of take up time. Going by that sniper rifle, though.
Not. Is that really fucking necessary?
It's a good thing we packed that holding cell.
Alright. 6 weeks ago, a client contacted me. He wanted small arms, contusions, a fucking missile launcher, you name it. He was willing to pay top dollar, too. It was a good deal. It was too good.
You supplied weapons for Blacklist Zero?
Hey, I supply a lot of people, okay? They don't usually go around targeting U.S. bases.
Who was it?
All I know is that they were talking about the attack on the embassy in Vienna, like they were fucking proud of it.
Hundreds of innocent people died in that attack.
Yeah, no shit! That's what I'm saying! This guy is a monster. He's a fucking ghoul, okay? And he doesn't leave loose ends.
Yikes.
You have the worst tattoos.
Am I right? This guy. What?
Who the fuck is this guy?
You turned yourself in for protection.
Keep you idiots from killing me over Guam, yeah.
Briggs, how are you about storing our new cargo?
My pleasure.
What does that mean?
It means you get to drink from the fire hose.
Dig up any information you can.
No.
Coben's
mystery. No. One of the nice things is we don't actually torture Coben. We're sort of civilized. It's sort of neat. Yeah, I mean, unfortunately, Sam Fisher tortures lots of other people. But we'll maybe talk about that next week.